Just in case you missed my last video, on the way over to La Paz, we stopped by the Cabo Pulmo National Park and did some free diving.
And I can't believe how much sea life we actually saw. It was literally like swimming inside of an aquarium.
All in the same day, we saw giant groupers, giant snappers, bull sharks, sea turtles, dolphins, and even whales. Cabo Pulmo. We're headed over to La Paz to swim with the whale sharks. That's originally why we came down here. That was the main goal. But when we got here, when we got to La Paz, the whale shark season wasn't open yet. There has to be a certain amount of whale sharks in the Sea of Cortez for the whale shark season to open. But yeah, we're heading to La Paz now. We probably have like, I don't know, a 5 or 6 hour drive. So if we took the freeway, it would be only maybe 2.5 hours, 3 hours to get over there. But we're gonna take the scenic route. Chairs, and we're gonna go do some shell hunting also. We found some shells and some cool looking coral too. Check this out. Ooh, look at that. Look at that. Piece of like a huge conch shell. Yeah. I don't know what that is, but that's pretty cool. To the beach over yonder. It's pretty soft, so we just gotta keep some momentum here. Yeah, I changed my mind. This is too soft. We need some all-terrain tires. We just got street tires. But the four-wheel drive in this thing is, well, it's pretty good. I'm trying to follow in other people's tracks. We made it.
Woo!
I thought it would be a little more firm, but yeah. So I think we have another maybe 40 minutes to an hour on this dirt road along the coast. And then the road goes up into the mountains. And I think we want to take a left, and then maybe like 20 or 30 miles, something like that, and we'll be in La Paz. Okay, so we drove on the dirt road for maybe like 40 minutes. I don't know how many miles, maybe 20 miles, something like that. And then I think we're at the road, the left you take to go up into the mountains to get through to La Paz. Hopefully this is the left, right by this sign. I ran over my GoPro. Anyways, I think it's still recording. It's the GoPro Hero 9. Yeah, I think it's okay. I think it's all good. But yeah, do me a favor, hit the like button. It's one click. If you're into travel content, subscribe to the channel. I think my GoPro is just fine and dandy, but yeah, I ran that shit over. Like, I was trying to make it go in between the tires. So, I just got a wee bit of bad news. I think when there was a fork in the road, we were supposed to go left, and we went right. And yes, this road that we came up, it turns into just a dried up riverbed. And yeah, not a whole lot of tire tracks for anybody going this way. So, we're gonna go backtrack about 10 miles-ish, and then take a left instead of a right. Shitty part is we're almost out of Captain Morgan. All right, so I went and found Wi-Fi and saw where the pin was that I dropped, and that's the turn we need to take to go up into the mountains through to the next highway in order to get to La Paz. So we took the left-hand turn like 5 miles too early. So we got a little way to go.
Problem is though, I don't know if there's a name of the road, and there's no cell service anywhere around here, so we can't use GPS. I just got screenshots of what the road looks like.
So we know where we're going now. But it's like 5 o'clock, so we're probably gonna camp here on the beach in the car. Maybe have a little bonfire. Check this out. This is a triggerfish. That's the one from the first Cabo Pulmo video that tried to bite the camera when I was looking at the stingray. Okay, boo-boo, look at what I found. I got something for you. Close your eyes.
Okay.
Okay. Now open them.
Ah!
What? It's just a cute little fishy.
Oh no. When did you find him?
I found him on the beach. No gasoline, no fire starters, no paper. It's that old school shit. There we go. Gonna go up like a match. Alrighty. Right in there.
Alright, we found our road. So it's probably like a 40-minute drive from the last town, something like that. The road isn't too bad.
So as you can see, the road really isn't that technical. I definitely wouldn't try it in a sedan, but it's not something that you need an off-road vehicle for. There aren't any really big boulders or anything like that. There's not too many steep hills. Four-wheel drive would definitely help out, but I wouldn't say you necessarily need it. I think you can make it without four-wheel drive. This is about as bumpy as the road got the whole time. Oh, and one more thing, there was no left-hand turn up into the mountains like I kept talking about. All you have to do is follow the road and it will eventually intersect with the highway.
I got 3 bars, 3G. I gotta check my crypto babies. Been a few days without any reception, without any cell service. A little bit red today. That's okay. A little bit red. Are you supposed to be outside the fence? Hey, mister, what do you think you're doing? We made it. Paved road. So we're headed to La Paz now. It's about 29 miles from where we popped out on the paved road, whatever highway we're on now. And this road is indeed very smooth. I feel like I'm on a magic carpet, just floating along, very smooth. Oh, ho, ho.